Good evening, everyone. It is really honored to have you here today to explore together the uncovering of self and to find a path to return to our own nature with our revered and knowledgeable Rinpoche, Kanpo Sodaji.
各位朋友，晚上好！非常荣幸大家今天能够相聚在这里，和我们尊贵的索达吉堪布仁波切一起探索如何认识自我并回归本性。
I feel it is a power that brings us together here, a power of dream deeply rooted in our hearts. Living in a world full of uncertainty, we are longing very much for a kind of reliable happiness.
今天是一股力量把我们汇聚在了一起，它深深地扎根在我们每个人的心中。因为生活在这样一个充满不确定性的世界中，我们都渴望获得一份可靠的幸福。
Sometimes when I sit on the vast grassland in the Larunga Five Science Buddhist Academy, the blue sky of the snow-covered plateau touches my heart with its purity.But when the dark clouds come, they block out my simple happiness all of a sudden.
有时，当我坐在学院广阔的草地上，便会被雪域高原上湛蓝而纯净的天深深地打动。但是，当乌云出现时，这种简单的幸福瞬间就被打破了。
Life is the same. The blue sky is our mind.Full of inherent happiness. But when the clouds of negative emotions show up, they simply cover the sunshine of happiness and make us depressed. There are so many things that can trigger the appearing of dark clouds in our lives. The leaving of a best friend, the breaking up with partner, the firing by boss, and so on.It seems like a reliable happiness is so far away, and sufferings are endless.
其实生活也是一样的，湛蓝的天就如同我们的心，与生俱来就蕴藏着无尽的幸福。但是当不良情绪的乌云出现时，幸福的阳光总是被遮蔽，失落也就随之而来。生活中有太多的事情会引发烦恼的乌云。好友的离去，伴侣的分离，工作的丢失等等，似乎可以信赖的幸福离我们很远很远，而痛苦却连续不断。
However, that is not true. Realizing that suffering is originated from our own behaviors and we have the power to change them, the future will be full of hope. Actually, what we need to do is just to accept.The fact that we are not perfect, and confess bravely that we have truly made many mistakes that hurt others and eventually hurt ourselves. And only with that sincerely self-exposing can we then move on to work for a better future without any load. It is like to blow away the dark clouds with the brave spirit of confession.And the sky of true self will be uncovered naturally.
事实上，如果我们意识到所有的痛苦都来自于我们的行为，并且我们有能力去改变它，未来就会充满希望。而我们要做的只是接受自我不完美的现实，勇敢地承认自己过去犯下的过错，对他人、对自己造成的伤害，真诚地将自己打开。放下包袱，才能更好地朝未来努力。如同一坦诚的风吹走烦恼的乌云，新的天空自然而然会呈现出来。
So, this is what our erudite Rinpoche will tell us today. A technique to remove sufferings, a way to uncover true self, and a path to return to our own nature.
因此，仁波切今天将以他的智慧告诉我们摆脱痛苦的方法。引导我们认识自我并回归本性。
Now let's welcome Rinpoche to give us the speech titled Uncover Yourself Through Vajrasattva Purification. Before he starts, we will chant together the eight noble auspicious ones.
下面让我们先一起念诵圣八吉祥颂，然后仁波切将为我们开示，题目是认识自我。
이제부터는이미저도내몸을침범을겨도밖으로다른감상도싫으면어떤바특지장나기시험사를내친구들은이신금성자고뜨기시험나연락만지면번조자나서라는데원기또반포를신길로아今天我们利用这个时间呢跟大家共同交流一个话题，也就是说自我的这种认识，实际上从我们佛教的一些教义来讲呢，忏悔的方法。
Today, I'd like to take this opportunity to discuss with you this topic, how to uncover ourselves.And I would like to discuss about this according to the Buddhist texts.
今天在座的各位啊，不管是东方人还是西方人，以及出家人也好，在家人也好，大家都有一种共同的信念，也就是说。通过多方面来认识自己，了解自己，这是我们对每个人来讲应该说是非常重要的，而且在座的人呢都是具有一定智慧的人，我相信所谓的认识自我呢，很多人会就极其深入的去思考，或者说是探讨就是这个意义。
People gathered here today, some of you are from the East, some from the East, and also we can see some lay people and monastic practices. And we are gathered here because we have this common faith, which is to recognize ourselves and to get to know more about ourselves. So I think this is very important.For any one of us. And as people with intelligence, I think we have a lot of ways to uncover and know ourselves. And some of you have think deeply upon these.
每个人认识自己的过程当中呢，也有一些好的方面来认识自己。譬如说，我有智慧。我有大悲心，我有真知真念，我有各方面的一些能力，包括我会辩论呐，我会处理人际关系啊，等等的。所以，我们对每个人就是反省自己或者观察自己的时候，很多人觉得我在这个世界上我在这个社会。群体当中我应该很不错的对自我呢应该有一些好的方面的评价或者说是认知。
During the course of knowing ourselves, we may have some positive, we may have some positive views upon ourselves, such as, I'm wise, I'm compassionate, and I have, I generate mindfulness a lot, and I can debate, and I can communicate with others well, things like this. So we all can reflect on ourselves, but I think we normally we have these good views of ourselves. We think, in society and in the community of ours,I'm good, I'm not bad.
我刚才就讲啊，就我们人对自我的认识方面也有这样好的方面的认识，还有呢，自我认识方面呢也有一些不好的方面的，就是我们每一个人应该无论是什么身份的人啊，就是像国家中通也好，企业家也好，明星也好，或者说是具有一定智慧的人也好，那么可能除了既个别的圆满一切功德的端除所有的障碍的人以外呢，在这个世界上所存在的怎么最伟大的最让人羡慕的这些人呢，实际上每个人都有一些不足的地方，也有一些缺陷和错误的地方。
Just now I said mostly we have positive views upon ourselves, but also we have something that we should enhance with and work with. No matter what kind of people you are, no matter you are the president, you are the businessman, you are the superstar, or you are someone with great wisdom. We might have done some misdeeds or made some mistakes in our life, because except those who have already attained full realization and eradication, those kind of great people, those kind of people that we admire, they may not commit any negativities. Except them, others might have something to work with, to enhance with.
今天我们参加这座这个讲座的这个讲座的有些人的话，可能表面上有些人就是长相很不错的，财富也极其圆满，然后自己的这个智慧啊各方面就是非常让人觉得极其佩服的，像这些人如果自己观察自己的时候，其实自己呢也有很多的地方不足啊，就因为我们每个人都有贪嗔痴，还有傲慢啊、嫉妒啊等等，就是这些烦恼。那这样的话呢，依靠这些烦恼，就是让我们在生活当中呢，应该会有许许多多的一些不良之处。
Today, people who attend this Dharma talk, I think some of you may have good wealth. Some of you may attain intelligence, and some of you are good looking. You are the people who are being admired by others, but.When you truly observe yourself or truly examine yourself, you may find that there are some shortage or some defilements of yours. Because I think considering about the attachment, anger, pride and jealousy, things like that, we may all have those. So if we do have those kind of things, then in the daily life, we can work on these kind of things.
这一点呢，就是古代的人就是说人非圣贤，孰能无过，也就是说我们一般的这个世间凡夫人呢，他并不是圣者一样的，所以没有一点过失的人呢，在我们这个实际上是很难以找到的。同时从心理学的角度讲呢，实际上我们对一种自我的认知呢，实际上是自我的一种改变。这样的自我的改变呢，就逐渐自己的提升自己的智慧和反省，就是自己就自己的缺陷。因此无论是从古人的这种哲学来看待，还是从现在的一些心理学角度看呢， 实际上自我认清或者说是所谓的忏悔呢，就是对每个人来讲，就是它是非常 有必要的一种这个需要思考的。
There's an old saying goes, to error is human. That means, as human beings, it's natural and understandable for us to commit activities, to make mistakes. So as ordinary human beings, we're not sublime ones, so we make mistakes. Those who don't make mistakes are very hard to find out.Nowadays, in psychology, they encourage people to rediscover themselves and to do self-reflection. In this way, they can change ourselves or to make improvement of ourselves. Also, at the same time, we should reflect on the shortage or defilements or the negativities we have done. So,Both from the ancient philosopher view and the modern psychology view, we should understand that to uncover ourselves is very important by confessing. We should think more about this point.
这样的这种忏悔或者说是认识自己的过错呢，可能有些人认为这是一种消极的。也是就增加了一些这个罪恶感，或者说是负罪感，但实际上并不是这样的。无论是从宗教也好，还是从我们实践的文学思想来看呢，那么自我认清是应该是一个很成功的人士的一种这个行为。
Some might have this thought that they think to confess or to admit one's mistakes is a behavior to act negatively or passively, and or to just by doing this we just increase the sense of our guilt. But in fact, in religion and in literature.Those great people, they just recognize, they just confess their negativities. They think this is something successful ones will do.
应该是在十八世纪，这个时候法国有一个非常著名的思想家。他也是当时的一个浪漫主义的代表人物，叫做是卢梭。他呢在晚年的时候就是写过一个叫做是忏悔书吧，就是忏罪的，就是他也就是说自己的一个自传。那这个自传当中呢，他就自我暴露，就是自己在一生当中所做的一些很粗鲁的就一般人来讲很难以自己暴露的一些情况呢，都讲得很清楚的。他说我的这个专辑里面呢，我的必被握住的地方我要这个写出来，我的善良忠厚高尚品德的地方呢我要这个写出来。所以从他的自传这个写了之后的话呢，应该说是后来的整个我们的这个社会也好，全球来讲，这本书就影响非常大。
We know the famous writer and great thinker Rousseau. He's a French writer, and he lived in the 18th century. He wrote a book named.The Confession. This is his autobiography. In the book, he just did some disclosure about himself. He uncovered those things did by him, no matter good or bad. In the book, he wrote, I've done something mean and ugly. I've also done something kind and honest. And some other things I've done is ethical and noble. For the mean and ugly things, I think he's brave enough to expose them, because I think for normal people, for ordinary people, it's very it's very difficult for us to expose like him. So I think later, autobiography is so famous and influential around this world, around our world.
其实当时他的这个卢梭的思想并没有就是现在那样，这个人们的思想就非常开放。但是呢，因为他很勇敢的说出自己一生当中所犯过的这些罪恶，这也是很正面的认识自我。所以这个道理我们在佛教当中所讲到的忏悔，实际上这个忏悔呢也应该通过各方面来就是认识自己，了解自己，而且自己所做的一些非常不如法的一些事情的话呢，那么在诸佛菩萨面前呢就进行这个发怒就进行忏悔，这种这个行为呢就是实际上也是自我认清、自我清净的一种最好的方法。
In fact, at that time, I think Rousseau's thought is not as open as the modern people's, but he's he's very brave to just admit his mistakes and just share these mistakes with others. In this way, he just uncover himself. And in Buddhism, we talk about and teach about confession through different ways. In Buddhism, we have many approaches and teachings and to do purification, to do confession. In this way, we can better know and better uncover ourselves. So, in Buddhism, also, we just confess, repent, and purify our negativities. In this way, we can feel more pure. And through this kind of behavior, it's a good way to clean up our mind stream, clean ourselves.
我刚才讲了，我们忏悔，实际上是忏悔就是对自我的另一种方式来认识。那么认识的过程当中呢，我们先应该认识自己的罪恶，这样的就是通过四种对治理，今天我们就是讲，就是说我们今天就是讲一下，就是通过这个忏悔啊，因为这个忏悔呢非常重要，像我们拉荣无名佛学院而言。今年应该开了这个二十二届的金刚萨埵法会。我们上师如意宝呢，就很早以前，就要求所有的四众弟子都要念念的忏悔，因为我们每个人，都不能说是自己的身口意都非常非常干净，所以呢，再过几天啊，我们。也会一年一度的金刚萨埵大法会，那么金刚萨埵大法会的时候呢，就是大家也通过这个金刚萨埵的本尊的这种修法，亲近啊，就是自己相续当中的各种各样的障碍，所以说呢，我们很有必要就是在这个之前呢，对金刚萨埵的这个这种佛像也好，或者说是我们这个金刚萨埵咒语的这个 念诵的一些灌修啊，就是这个重要性呢，大家应该要搞清楚。
Just as I mentioned, to do confession is a good way to uncover ourselves. During this process, first, you should identify and acknowledge what you have done wrong. And today, I'd like to mainly talk about the four opponent powers. Because confession is very important, in our Larongar, each year we will hold the Dhamma Assembly of the Vajrasattva. For now, we have been holding it 22 times. And early on, my teacher, His Holiness, Jigme Pentu Rinpoche, asked the four-folded disciples to attend this Dhamma Assembly to confess their negativities. Because the three doors of us, the body, speech, and mind, have accumulated negative karmas, so we have to take the chance to attend the assembly to confess our negativities. And some days later, the Dhamma Assembly of this year will begin. So I hope at that time we can try our best to rely on Vajrabodhisattva to purify our negativities. So I think before this event, before this Dhamma gathering, it's necessary for me to inform you or introduce you the importance to recite the mantras and visualize the Bodhisattva, the Vajrasattva.
每天通过每个人做一些忏悔，就像我们人需要每天的早上起来洗脸刷牙，需要洗漱，然后每天呢也需要就是洗澡沐浴，同样的道理，就这是我们对身体的这样的一种洗涤。实际上我们的内心当中的垢染肮脏不堪的这些东西呢，也需要有一种这种智慧的甘露水来就是进行洗掉，就进行净化，就这是非常有必要的。
The reason why I think everyone should do confession every day, because we wash our hands and face every morning, we brush our teeth every morning, and every day we may have shower, and sometimes we may have bath, and we clean the body of ourselves. But likewise, in our mind, there are some dirt and stains too. So we need the nectar of wisdom to clean the stain and dirt of our inner mind. I think this is very important and necessary.
我们的上师如意宝，法王呢，他也是就向导我们每个弟子啊，就也是在一生当中或者说一年当中会深刻以造许许多多的这种罪业。如果一段时间就是没有这样忏悔的话呢，很有可能就是到一定的这种罪业到一定的时候呢，就是很难以忏尽。所以我们所有的人在开发会的过程当中呢，都每年的通过这个金刚萨埵的念修啊，就是观想来这个忏悔自己的罪业。所以说呢我们也希望我们在座的所有的各位啊，我相信大家很多人有些是在现场就是有机会参加这样的法会，有些的话呢可能不能直接参加，但是通过网络的直播也对这个七天当中的法会呢 有机会参与。所以呢，我在这里也是再三这个强调啊，就是大家有机会的话，尽量参与这样的这种法会，然后净化自己的人心，提升自己的智慧和这个道德。
His Holiness encourage every disciple of his to take part in this Dharma assembly and to confess the confess the negativities committed by our three doors. So I think we should not do it just during 1 year, but do it during our whole life. Because if we don't confess, we don't purify, then if the negativities sometimes ripen, then the results will be horrible, will be very hard for us to experience. So I hope those of you who want to attend this Dharma assembly of Vajrasattva, I hope you could rely on Buddha Vajrasattva and chant his mantras to purify your negative karma. And now I think people today we gathered many of you here. I think for this Dharma assembly, you can just show up in our Larungar and to attend it yourself, to chant mantras, chant and practice here. But also you can attend this Dharma assembly on the internet for altogether 7 days. So I repeatedly emphasize that please take this opportunity to attend this Dharma assembly in order to purify our negativities and in order to enhance our wisdom and some good qualities.
就是我们今天就是讲的是过一段时间法会当中也主要修的金刚萨埵啊，我想不管是东方人还是西方人，大家都需要通过这种方式来铲除自己的罪障。那这样的话，所有的这些罪业的修法呢，实际上四对治理就是非常重要。四对治理呢，相当于，比如说一个人，他吃了这个过期的一些食物，然后就生病病得很严重，后来，他去看病，就是看一个医生，那么这个医生呢，就是相当于是说一对治理。这个医生是说一对治理。
So, today, what I am going to talk about, and is the Vajrasattva practice, and this which will be also practiced and chanted in this Dharma assembly. I think, no matter you are from East or the West.To rely on this kind of approach to purify negativities is very potent. And we, speaking of this kind of practice, we have to mention the four opponent powers, which is very important. Just as someone who has had some rotten food, some food just expired, the just rotten food.After he ate that food, he felt sick. He felt sick. So he went to the doctor to look at his sickness. So the doctor is the power of resolve.
这个医生就是他当时看病的时候，就是所医治的。对境也叫做所以对之内，就是相当于是我们就造了这个罪意以后，自己知道错了，然后在谁面前忏悔呢，应该找到一个像医生一样的佛菩萨或者说上师，就像我们佛教里面有三世五佛，还要有八十位佛，还有呢就是金刚萨埵等等，就是这些是所谓的所以对治理。
So the sick man went to the doctor to see his sickness. So the doctor here is the power of resolve. And when we recognize and identify the wrongdoings of our hours, then we should find somebody to confess with. Those are the objects for us to confess. Those objects can be Buddhas, the 13 or 18 Buddha, or Vajrasattva Buddhas, or our guru, root guru. So those kind of supreme objects is the ones we rely to confess.
第二个就叫做是言欢对治力。言欢对治力呢在自己最后观察自己在人生当中犯到的错误是非常严重的。就像我刚才讲的，一个人吃了这种已经过期的这种食物的时候，最后他疼痛非常严重，就这个时候他会发现就是我吃错了非常不好，然后自己心里面有极大的一种后悔心，就是这叫做是这个厌患对治力。
And the man found out he has taken the wrong food, and it's like in our life, we should reflect on our, we should identify the wrongdoings of our hours. So by recognizing that, we will develop a heartfelt regret. This is the power of regret.
第三个就刚才他已经吃了这样的药之后呢就自己发现就从此之后呢根本不会使用这样的这种过期的食物。那同样的他犯了自己的这样的错误之后呢在诸佛菩萨面前就是发强烈的誓言，从此之后呢再也不会造作，就是这就是犯悔对治力。
When he find out he just taken some when he find out the cause of his sickness is the rotten food, then he made his mind to never eat that kind of food again. So likewise, when we recognize that we've made mistakes, then we should make aspirations in front of Buddhas that we will not do the negative actions ever again. This power, we call that the power of resolve.
第四步就叫先行对治力。先行对治力呢，刚才已经照到了医生，照到了自己的病根，从此之后再也不会就是吃错，或者是这样，就是不会再做。但是呢，你光这样，你的病，你以前所犯过的错误不一定很改好。所以你作为一个生病的这样的病人呢，医生开的药就是你要必须使用。那同样的道理，我们通过先行对治力、金刚萨埵的观修、念注意等等这种方式来将自己所犯过的这些罪业呢一一忏悔，就这就叫做是先行对治力。
The third one I want to talk about is the power of remedy. So the sick man just went to the doctor and he knows the cause of his sickness and he made his mind not to eat that kind of food again. But if he don't follow the advice of the doctors and don't take the medicines, then his sickness will not be cured as well. So at this time, he need to take the medicine and follow the doctor's advice. This is like as we just visualize Vajrasattva, we practice Vajrasattva, and we chant Vajrasattva's mantra and to do purification. And this power, we call it the power of remedy.
那这样的话，我们今天呢，我那个发王如意宝的这个金刚萨埵修法如意宝珠啊，其实这个简单的仪轨呢，也是这样一个四种对治力。因此，我 在这个仪轨上呢，就是跟大家简单的介绍一下，就是四对真理的忏悔方法。
Today, I'd like to give you a brief introduction of His Holiness, one of His Holiness liturgy, titled titled Vajrasattva Purification. The liturgy is titled Vajrasattva Purification, the liturgy of the wish-fulfilling jewel. And today, I will teach it according to the four opponent powers. And I will just follow the four opponent powers to give you this teaching.
아람든추천점수위바커다위단탄도링디과든도제서가서다와디빈다자르치시그니도처남롱르키체르조치총지이시고즈르숍주름초당위예든거를함메르서这个衣柜呢实际上是我们要观想的时候在自己前面的虚空当中呢莲花和月轮上一切三世诸佛的终极金刚萨埵就是身世就像这个交界的月亮一样就是白色的然后呢书册临出它是以包身这个服饰啊然后智慧的光芒呢就是现于整个世界就所以这是也就是说我们如果自己的信心和迷踪的深远次第到达一定成熟的时候你可以观想双圣的金刚萨埵如果还没有到达这种境界之前的话呢你在自己的前面就是观想一个我们平时在照片当中所看到的一个金刚萨埵的这个佛像就是这是我们就是也叫做是所以对之内也就是说我们在忏悔的时候呢最好就是用这样的金刚萨埵
In front of me, in an ocean of vast offering clouds, appears Lord Vajrasattva, white like the moon, upon a lotus and moon seat, with one face and his two hands holding the bell and vajra. He sits in full lotus with the perfect Sambhogakaya adornments and emanates rays of wisdom throughout the ten directions.So first, please visualize that in front of you, there is a seat made of lotus. And on the lotus, there is a perfectly full moon. And on this seat appears the Vajrasattva, who is the emanation of all the Buddhas of three times. The Vajrasattva is white in color, and he's holding...his two hands are holding the bell and the vajra, and he is wearing the 13 Sambhogakaya adornments. The wisdom of his wisdom rays just radiates to the 10 directions of all the worlds. If you can practice the...generation stage or the perfection stage, then you can visualize the double-bodied Vajrasattva. If you're just a beginner please visualize a single-bodied Vajrasattva. This Vajrasattva is just like the pictures we often see. So this is the power of reliance.
我们要忏悔的时候就在佛教当中所讲的金刚萨埵啊其实最殊胜的一个对境因为金刚萨埵在营底的时候他这样发过愿将来谁能持诵我的名号能念诵我的咒语的这些人呢无论造什么样的这个罪业但愿他们呢都所有的罪业得以清洁如果 他们就是不能这样的话，那我现在不要称呼。但是后来漫长的时间当中积累资粮，修持这个善法之后呢，他已经获得了佛果。所以呢，我们念诵或者说修持任何一个法呢，就不如就在忏悔过程当中就金刚萨埵是最殊胜的。
Vajrasattva is the most supreme object for us to do purification, because when he is at the course stage, that means when he, before he becomes Buddha, he made this aspiration that anyone who recites my mantra, no matter what kind of activities he or she committed, if the activities cannot be purified, then I will not attain Buddhahood. So during such a long time, Vajrasattva just accumulate merit, and then finally he attained his Buddhahood. So according to this, we should understand that by reciting his mantras, then our negativities can be purified, and he is the most supreme object for us to do come to rely on doing purification.
第二步就是我们说，这个第二个对峙，就严欢对峙你。那么，藏文当中这样讲的，杰布拉玛多日杰森，我们一旦这样念功呢，得说。냠탁샘치남티지에지선점브름조통메디네다바르드링어이티르득동남지르드콘드득송다오농규적뱀토르장샤지시第二步对治方法，也就是说金刚萨埵刚才前面讲的一样，就是他在无数劫当中为了就是众生啊而发了愿，就是最后成就的。那么他会用智慧的眼就是关注我们这些众生无始以来依靠身欲意所造的这个无量无边的罪业。那么我们今天呢也是现发现，就像一个人吃了毒药一样的，就是非常的这个后悔。因此今天呢在所有的诸佛菩萨面前进行忏悔的意思。
Oh, Guru Vajrasattva, please recall your great aspiration in the past. I and other suffering sentient beings,supplicate you, please keep us in your care with great compassion. From beginning this time until now, we have committed many evils with body, speech, and mind. As though I had taken poison, I now deeply regret them and thoroughly confess them all. This is the second opponent powers, which is called the power of regret.Just now, we said Vajrasattva Buddha, just during eons of time, he just accumulated virtues for us to fulfill his aspiration to become the Buddha of purification. So now we can imagine that he is looking at us with his eyes full of wisdom. And then the, the negativitiesAccumulate the negativities created by our three doors from beginning this time will be purified by in the presence of Buddha Vajrasattva. So first, we should identify the mistakes, the misdeeds, and then generate a sense of regret. And later, we just can confess in front of the Buddha Vajrasattva.
这样的这种忏悔呢，其实实践当中也有，因为自己认识自己的错误。不知道在座的看过没有？以前这个印度的甘地啊，他在自己的传记当中也说过，他在15岁的时候，他透过自己各个的这个金座的一些一块镜子。然后来呢，他自己就有一种负罪感，特别后悔，然后他就想给自己的父亲就坦白， 但是呢，他又害怕，就是一方面是父亲就是对责骂他，另一方面呢，他没有这个勇气。后来，他就写一个就是参过的这种这个自己的这种书啊，就是信啊，就然后呢，就是就进行交给他的父亲。但是他的父亲呢，在这个病床上，就他陷得非常的痛苦，就是他这个父亲啊，就是当时他一直这个哭着。但后来呢，通过他的父亲的这种这个哭泣，他自己的一种负罪感，然后他就发愿，就是从此之后呢，就是再不做。但这次呢，深深地认识到他自己，作为一个人呢，吐这样的这个自己的亲人的东西是非常就是不好。就所以说，我们大家都知道，这个印度甘地呢，应该在历史上是非常伟大的人物。但实际上，像他那样的话呢，到一定的时候也是知道自己是犯了非常大的这种罪。
In the world, we know some people, they have their own ways to confess, to do purification for themselves. Like the great man Gandhi, when he was 15, he stole the bracelet of his brothers, which is made of gold. And after that, after he had done that, he just felt so regretful. He intended to tell this to his father. But he's afraid that his father is going to scold him. And also, he didn't have that courage. So he decided to write a note to his father. At the time, his father was seriously sick and was lying on bed. When seeing the note, his father is crying badly. But I think, through the tears of his father, it's like the water just cleaned away his guilt of this incident. So I think from Gandhi's story, we can just think he's great, right? He's great, but he's brave enough to identify his negativities, and he just generates deep regret after he's done something bad, especially to steal the things from his relatives, his brothers.
下面第三个对治方法，新出出来吧，就是讲没过来那么不讲。怎么先就怎么做了？前面学过无用做，得当先进。谈起去，谈起年去，跟大家敲当，他们我这跟大家你都责任做。那么这个是刚才就讲到是这个，就反悔对治你。那所谓的反悔对治你呢？他就是知道，就是将来，就是。即使遇到生命危险的话呢，也不会再犯这样类似的这个错误。所以希望这个金刚萨埵和所有的诸佛菩萨呢，应该给我进行这个宽恕啊。通过这样的忏悔之后呢，自己也能获得这个暂时和究竟的洗涤。
From now on, even if it costs me my life, I will never commit any non-virtuous acts. Oh, Protector, please watch us with your compassionate eyes. Bestow liberation with your gentle hand. Out of stupidity and ignorance, I have not kept my samaya properly. Guru Protector, Vajradhara, I pray to you for protection and liberation. Guru of all sentient beings, your nature is great compassion. To you, I go for refuge. Please purify the samaya that I and other sentient beings break or lose. Grant us all the common and all uncommon supreme siddhis now.This is the third opponent powers, which is called the power of resolve. So just now, we said, because we already identified those things that we did wrong, so we should make our mind not to do them ever again, even at the cost of our own life. So to bear this kind of mindset, we confess in front of the Buddhas and Vajrasattvas, we supplicate to them and hope they can forgive us, can purify us. So I think through this kind of confession, we can gain the common and uncommon accomplishments.
刚才我讲的就是认识自己的错误，并且呢当下就发现自己，这是在修行当中非常重要。我们藏传佛教有一个非常著名的一个案例啊，就是说本公家次正家吧，本公家次正家吧，他在家的时候呢当过土匪，打架很厉害的，他身上偏有好几把刀，就非常厉害了。他后来出家的时候呢，刚开始还有这个习气。有一次在一个施主家里念经的时候呢，他就冒生，就是这个施主的人全部都出去了，然后出去之后呢，他在家里就最后看到以前我们藏地的很多的这个茶叶呢，就是放在一个袋子里面，然后他心里面想，就是施主的人全部都没有了，我今天应该偷一点茶，然后就他就悄悄地去在口袋里面就准备就是茶袋里面的这个吐茶叶的时候，他突然就是用自己的真知真念来已经察觉到之后呢，就是他就大声的呼唤，就是让这个施主家里的人过来，就是我在偷东西，你们应该把我的手腕就是砍掉，就他当时这个发现，而且呢就是从此之后他自己也立即忏悔。所以在本公家的这样的自我认识和自我发现呢，在我们藏传佛教的历史当中呢也是非常这个特殊的。所以我刚才也讲了，我们很多人可能会犯错误，但是犯错误的时候呢，你会认识自己啊，我今天就是做的不对的，那我好好的要这个金刚萨埵面前忏悔，以后呢尽量的不做，就是这个是非常关键。
I just mentioned we should identify ourselves. Yes, we should identify the mistakes immediately at the moment we made them, and then to rectify or correct them immediately or at the very moment. There's a famous story in Tibet. The role of this story is named The role of the story, his name is just I mentioned, Rinpoche mentioned also. Before he got ordained, he was a bandit, he was a bad person, and he used to fight with others a lot, and he carried some lives with him all the time. But after he became a monk, there's some habitual patterns. So one time when he was in the home of a patron, there was a time when the room was just nobody but himself, and at that time he saw a pack of tea, and he saw, oh, I may need this tea in the future when I practice. So because there's nobody, so he just stole some of the teas. But just at the right just at the very moment, he just noticed, he identified this stealing mistake. He stopped there and called out, come and rest me. I'm a bad person. I'm stealing others' tea. So I think this is very good because when you just do something bad, do something wrong, you should notice it. You should acknowledge it at the very moment. And also this kind of this story of Ben Gong Zhao is very famous in Tibetan history, and this is something and some person that we should learn from. So as people, we make mistakes. This is natural and understandable, but we should recognize that we are not right. We did something wrong. We should recognize this and do confession, and then make our mind not to do that again.
이소라 답이 도비지 창월고는 온반지 사동 범척 지블이나 사위 담스기 년바가 샹브른지로 삼아야 아 다지시 디스거나 주로 우리 통고 이종 현신 대지리 소위의 현신 대지리나 아 有很多方法，包括修菩提心呐、修空心呐、还有这个转佛塔，还有就最重要的，我们普遍的是修金刚萨埵。那修金刚萨埵的时候呢，在《大圆满前行》里面所讲一样的，就是金刚萨埵观想在头顶上，然后降下这个甘露啊。就是将自己的所有的身体和语言心灵的障碍全部这个净除。我是经常在想啊，就是我们现在城市里面的人呢，就经常这个有沐浴洗澡的这样的机会。其实在这个时候呢，边念金刚萨埵心咒，边呢就是做这个洗澡啊，就其实这是也是一种这个方法。通过这样的一种方法呢，就是将自相续当中的所有的罪障得以这个清净。因此在这里也讲了，我们最好是念这个40万遍金刚萨埵心咒。通过40万遍金刚萨埵的话呢，那么即使在密宗当中的犯的严重的罪业呢也得以清净，更何况说是其他的罪业。因此特别希望啊，就今天参加的在座的人呢、就是有些人可能认为啊40万遍太多了，但其实呢我们造的罪就是可能更大的，就如果我们自己罪也得以清净的话，那这个40万遍呢就是其实是并不是很多的。我们每一个人呢就是应该是需要这个忏悔，如果通过忏悔得以清净的话呢，那我们身体也健康，心情也快乐，做任何事情呢，就是会圆满的。
Thus should one pray, just relying on these 4 opponent powers, we chant the mantra of Vajrasattva Om Bandha Sadu Hum according to one's ability, and completion of 400,000 times of mantra restore broken root tantra samayas. So this is the first power.The power of remedy. To actually do the purification, there are many ways, such as we can generating and practicing bodhicitta. We can abide in the state of emptiness, and also we can practice this Vajrasattva purification. As it is said in the words of my perfect teacher,it asks us to visualize Vajrasattva visualize Vajrasattva above our crown, that means above our head, and then visualize the nectar dripping down from Vajrasattva into our own body. In this way, the negativities accumulated by the 3 doors can be purified.Often, I think nowadays people in cities can take the opportunity of shower and bath to do this practice. How to do it is like, you can do it like this. When you are having shower or taking a bath, you can chant the heart mantra of Vajrasattva while you are showering, while you are bathing. This is a, I think this is a very good way. So in this way, you can just purify both your body and mind. And it is said just in the liturgy, it's better for us to chant 400,000 times of this heart mantra. Because if we do this, even the most severe negativities, such as the violating of the root tantra, can be purified, let alone other negativities. Therefore, I hope anyone who attends this Dhamma assembly, who wants to purify themselves, should chant chant 400,000 times. If you think this number is if you think this amount is huge, think about your negativities. It's more huge than this number. So I don't think this number is big, because we need to confess, we need to purify. By doing this, we can gain gain purification both in body and mind. And when we do things, we'll find it's easy to be successful.
今天很多人利用自己的时间，我们共同交流啊，很有意义，非常感谢大家。
And today we take this opportunity and time to share our knowledge together. I feel so gratitude. Thank you all.
So thank you very much, Rinpoche, for your gracious teaching about the practice of four powers of confession to help us uncover ourselves.
感谢仁波切智慧而又亲切的开示，引导我们通过四对日语的忏悔方法来认识自我。
It is so vivid that I can still sense the pure and crystal clear Vajrasattva sitting quietly on a white lotus in the sky, watching us with compassionate eyes, and with the white light of Vajrasattva shining on us. Deep in my heart, I arose the courage to confess and the determination of not doing it again. I believe, relying upon Vajrasattva, the load of our negative actions and emotions can be ultimately removed.
仁波切生动地讲述，使我仿佛感觉到水晶般透明无垢的金刚萨埵，就静静地安坐在空中的白莲花上，满怀慈悲地注视着我们。他发出的白光照耀着我们，给了我忏悔的勇气和从不再犯的决心。我相信，依靠金刚萨埵的力量，我们一定可以彻底放下罪业的负担。
Thank you, everyone present or on the internet. Thank you for your listening and reflecting on this topic, which I think will throw some light on your way of self-uncovering. Wonderful time always flies quickly. Although the time we spend together is so short, the vivid teaching and the wonderful experience will certainly be preserved in my memory, and I think in your memories as well. Hope that one day you will find that your mind has never been changed, just like the sky never being affected by the clouds.
同时也感谢在场以及网络上的听众，感谢各位的参与。美好的时光总是稍纵即逝，尽管今天的相聚十分短暂，但生动的开示以及美好的经历将永远留存在你我的记忆当中。愿将来有一天您会发现，天空从未真正被乌云遮蔽过， 而我们的心从未被烦恼染污过，一如本初纯净而光明。
At 9:30, our Honorable Rinpoche will give another teaching of Vajrasattva in Tibetan without any translation, and two transmissions of Vajrasattva will be given. One is from Mipon Rinpoche, the other is from his Holiness Jinmei Pongchö Rinpoche. So you are very welcome to attend. Before that, let's dedicate first the merits we've collected in this session to all sentient beings.
等一会儿我们会休息十分钟，在9:30还有一场仁波切的纯藏文的开示，内容也是关于金刚萨埵忏悔。仁波切会赐予我们两个珍贵的传承，一个是来自 MAP 仁波切的金刚萨埵修法仪轨，另一个是法王如意宝的金刚萨埵修法如意宝珠。到时欢迎大家的参与。现在让我们一起把刚才的功德回向给一切众生。
苏那么的一团结的把你的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋友的朋